After we have done our preliminaries, we move on to our letterhead. So because we want our letterhead on the first page only, we go to the design tab and we look for what says different, odd, and even pages. Then we select that. An additional tool was added on the date but corrected later down in the video. I already prepared a video speaking to different letter styles, so I'll leave the link in the description box below. It is important to remember that in the indented style, the first line of each paragraph moves away from the margin. The letter that we're preparing has a numbered list in the body of the letter. So we go to the tab labeled numbering, then we select the format that we would like. So the format that we're using has numbers with no punctuation. We select that, then we decrease the indent to have the numbers starting from the left margin, then we begin typing. We then simply press the enter key twice to type the paragraph or the list that follows. So now we're ready for number 2. We simply go back to the numbering tab and click, and then the number 2 will automatically appear. Here we're noticing that the paragraph under the fourth heading moves to a second page. We do not want the paragraph separated, so we're going to move all of number 4 to the second page. So for our continuation page, we have the number 2 in the center, which indicates that you are now onto the second page of your letter. Aligned left, we have the receiver's name. Then to the right, we have the same date that was used on the first page of our letter. This, however, depends on the style of the letter that we're preparing, as this is the indented format. The continuation page for other formats will be shown in subsequent clips. Thank you. So now we have our complementary clause aligned right, as again, remember we are preparing the indented format. Then we have our signature block and our designation. After our designation, we then have our attachment notation aligned to the left. So remember, for any continuation page that you are preparing, it should begin with the number 2, it should have the receiver's name, and also the date that was used at the beginning of the letter. Also remember that for an indented style letter, the first line of each paragraph should move away from the margin. As you can see, we now have a block style letter as all lines are beginning at the left margin. For the continuation page, we have the number 2, the date, and the receiver's name beginning the second page, and these are aligned left. So in order, we have the page number, the date, and then the receiver's name. Our semi-blocked letter with our date typed from the center of the page, and on our continuation page we have the number 2 aligned left, the receiver's name aligned left, and our date aligned to the right. Please note that the date is typed in the same line as the receiver's name.